Hi, it's Maggie Davis, aka Minnie Minx on YouTube and the Captain. I just wanted to share with you this handmade vintage junk journal. It's got an easy tie closure. I've used twine there. It's got a few wee beads at the bottom, star beads on there. I'm hoping it stands. Yeah, it stands. I'll do it like that so you can see. I'm gonna call it Birds and Flowers. Bird on the front, and I've done stamping here and there inside. That's some flowers, etc. The size of it is 8 inches by roughly 5¾ inches. That's 20 centimeters by 15. I have used zigzag stitch on the cover. Quite a striking cover on this. It's got one signature. There is roughly 66 pages, then making 132 sides. But there's also flip-ups, flip-outs, etc., which create more space. There's coffee stain papers, there's plain paper, lined paper, mindful pages, envelope-type pages, there's book pages, there's pockets. As I said, I've done flip-ups and flip-outs, stamped images, there's coin envelope pockets, and some ephemera have been, some have been stuck down and some are in the pockets. So I've used eyelets and just made this easy tie closure. If you didn't like this twine, could take it out and just loop something else in. Really is entirely up to yourself. But I do like the cover. I like the flowers and butterfly, etc., and bird on that. So I'll just quickly show you. So this is for sale on my Etsy, Minx Creations UK. That's quite striking paper, isn't it? So I've done a bit of stamping here and there. It says a new beginning I've put on. I fussy cut out that ladybird so you can print in here, journal in here. Done a bit of stamping up the top and off this flower big stamp. So Dance in the Rain I've got there. This is a little flip up, a little label, so you could put something underneath this. Put a picture on there, and this is like a stub off that, but it's a memorandum there. So you could journal on the back. Just creating a bit more space here. That one's got a little flower. So any of the little stamped images like that, you could colour in, paint, washi colour, whatever. Felt pens, etc. That's beautiful paper, isn't it? Yeah, it's a printout. So I've done a bit of stamping up here with, don't know what it is, words. And this one flips up. Little flip up page there, creating a little, creating extra space, and this one flips up. I've got the word beautiful there, and this one flips out like that, creating more space. And then we've got an envelope page here. So we've got, what did I put in here? It's coffee stained envelope, and got a little couple of them that you could glue down somewhere and make into tuck spots. That's entirely up to yourself. That's a nice page, isn't it? Peacock feathers there. I love the colours on that. This one, I've just stapled it on, so it's like that. You could journal on the back on top of that, and I've made a little pocket, I've stamped that little flower on it, and just to show you. But you could also, I've just put that in it, it's a little book. But what you could actually do, if you didn't want it, I've put on my metal paper clip, is on one of the pages you could actually glue down the sides across the bottom and up the side, make a tuck spot at the back, and then you've got a tuck spot in here as well. That's entirely up to yourself. I've inked the edges, I think, of that. On some of them I've inked, that was coffee stained line paper. So a little envelope coin pocket there, and then this little one, there's nothing in it, I've just, I bet you can't get it open now, that nothing in this one, because it is a, what I'm calling, an eatsy beatsy tootsy wootsy little pocket, just like that. And I've just put it up the top. Again, you could glue that part of it on a page and make it into a tuck spot. And we've got this one, and I've done a little bit of stamping up the top there. And this one says here, today I am grateful for, and you could write something in there. And this little pretty girl, and a bit stamping on it. Nourish your soul. Sure, I made this paper myself. Sure, when I was playing about with Photoshop, so I've printed it off and ripped it up. ripped it out and stuck it on the top. So it's a flip-up page. It says nourish the soul, and you could put something underneath or on the back of it. So we've got dare to begin, and we've got tea paper there that I bought out of a shop in Leith Walk in Edinburgh. And this one's a little, I've stamped on the edge, and then it's a little like statement, and then it, like an invoice, and it folds up, folds out like that, like a pull-out. I love that paper too here. A little bit stamping down the bottom here, so on coffee stain paper. And this one, the earth laughs in flowers, is what I've put. So this one flips up the way, flips up like that. You've got a little bit stamping here and there, just creating a little bit more space on the journal. So this could be used as a journal, a diary, a planner, a unique keepsake, and would make a lovely gift. And you could use it for anything. You might be religious, and you might want to write your thoughts in it, or, you know, if you teach a class or something like that, or flip up here. Or you might just want to use it as a journal every day and write, or as a diary. So I've put this big tag and I've stamped that flower on it, and you could journal on that. Really is up to yourself, or you could, as I say in most of my videos, if you've been away and you've got a ticket stub or something of a place that you went and you really liked, you could clip in your ticket stub and whatever and write something in it. So you've got a couple of die cuts here and a little one of these. I've just put in that envelope there. So it's up to yourself how you want to use it. As a diary, planner, you might be keeping fit, we've been summer here or whatever, and you might want to journal what you've done each day. So a little flip up here, just like that, to create a bit more space. And I put this vintage lady on it, a bit stamping off this flower. It says real, not perfect. I like that. And then this side, got a little bit of coffee stain paper here and a little bit stamping there. Some die cuts that I've glued on there. Life is in the detail. So we've got a little coin pocket there. And then this one's just been folded in half and I've stamped it. So it's just been done onto paper. Just like that. Shouldn't eat it. But you could put picture or something in there. Or you could glue up the sides, have that as a tuck spot, or you could have it that way on your page. You could glue across the bottom, glue up that side, and you could have it stuck in down the sides across the bottom. Have that as a tuck spot and then the tuck spot inside it. So just ways of using bits of paper, etc., to create more space. We've got this one that flips out. Now she's cute, hey? So I think it's a face on, could be a teacup or something. I really like it. That's why I'm calling it, what did I say? Bird and flowers. Love yourself more on this page. And then this little one, little invoice or whatever, flips out. And this one flips up like that. And we've got a little bit stamping down the bottom. First time using these stamps. I hadn't used them before. I've got them on not too long ago. You are more capable than you know. And I've used these flower ones before. There's a mindful page here. But not the stamping that's up on the top. Some of the stamps, it's my first time. So a mindful page, you can sit for 5 minutes and colour it in. Then we've got the centre of the signature, and it was done with a little envelope, a coffee stained, and you've got another one of these little envelope coin envelope is what we'll call it in there. But you could use that somewhere else in the journal, and then on the other side, it's just one of these that you've seen already throughout it, just showing you that there's a space there for putting something in. So that mindful page could be coloured in, and then this one up. So this was a new stamp, and this was a new stamp up there. And then this one, it says embrace the possibilities, and this little girl, and she flips out like that. So you could journal on the back and underneath, and I like that. Then we've got this vintage person that says this moment I've stamped a bit of a flower on it, so you could colour that in. And this one, I think this one flips up like that, just creating a bit more space in your journal. And then I've got a little bit of stamping at the top there. And then this one, Feed Your Soul, beautiful daffodils, I think they are, and flips up like that. And this is a large tag that I've stamped, so it could be taken off and put somewhere else. Coffee stain paper on there. And then this one's a little pocket. So I've put something in this just so that, you know, one of these little things like that. So again, this pocket could be glued elsewhere. And I do like it because it looks like it's got lace and things on it. It kind of matches with the flower theme, the birds and flowers. Although the bird seems to be only on the front cover, but never mind. And this one, I flip it sideways there. And then you've got Chase the Sun and a little flip up on lined paper there. This one. And then this one. And it flips out like that. So it's just creating a little bit extra space for you, as I said, stamping the butterflies. Got a little bit of ephemera in here. That way or that colour, whatever you want to use it in this. So these could be tuck spots in your journal. Just glue part of it down, either at the side of your page or at the bottom corner, and you could tuck a photo or something in it. And then this one, I've just used a paper clip at the side here, and it's just a printout of a page, necessary materials checklist and a wish list. But you could journal on that, journal on the back of it. It creates a little bit more space in this vintage handmade junk journal. Make yourself proud, a little picture there of a girl. And then this one. So we've got some stamping down there and a flip up. And then this beautiful page. And I do like that. Very vibrant and colourful. And then these pages. What does that one say? Just keep going. And this one. That one says explore. And you've got another pocket here, which I'll no bother taking out. Because you're seeing a similar one. This one. Like that. And then this page. And then a little envelope here. You've got a little bit of ephemera in there. So those die cuts, similar die cuts that you've seen. And these are just done out of paper that you could glue somewhere in the journal. So that's a coffee stained envelope that's in here. And I've stamped that side on it. Flip up there. A little bit stamping at the bottom. And then this one, take a breathe. Take a breath. Take a breathe. Flip out like that. And then this beautiful page over here. Well, and this one, love it. And then Once in a Lifetime with a Vintage Lady and some stamping. Aspire to Inspire. And I've stamped that in a flip up. And then this one flips up too. And you've got three stamped butterflies at the bottom that you could colour in. That flips up to create more space for your journal. And that stamped image. Everything is figurable. I hope that says that. And a bit stamping in the corner. The most beautiful thing there, and the butterfly, and of course it is. And I've stamped a little bit flower on there, and that is the back of your journal. So, as I said, this is for sale. And I don't know if I showed you. The centre has got those little beautiful beads on them. So they're stars. I thought it went, the colours went. So this is for sale on my Etsy, Minx Creations UK. Have a lovely day and keep cool, because it's been absolutely roasting. So many thanks for watching. Bye.